people celebrate their birthdays or their anniversaries. Tonight, Frank Cimbali is celebrating his financial downfall. He's leaving his home, or rather, his home is leaving him. Everything not completely paid for is being taken back, and nothing is completely paid for.
You seem distracted. Is there something wrong?
Have you seen Anna Lays?
She's trouble for you, Frank. You should never have let her stay here.
Thank you.
Annalise!
What's wrong?
I don't know. She's not answering.
Anna Lays! Hey, Anna Lays, you in there?
As a result of the death by overdose of a girl he barely knew, Frank is suspected, interrogated, and released. His future, however, still remains very hazy, but destiny watches over him in the person of the evil but providential Morph.
A week, Morph? What took so long?
The wheels of justice move slowly.
You have attracted much too much attention to yourself in this affair.
What the hell has that got to do with anything? Who cares about attracting attention to myself? That girl is dead.
Of course, of course. It was a tragic accident. However, there are other matters your guardian wished me to discuss with you.
My former guardian.
You have squandered a small fortune in the past 2.5 months. You're heavily in debt with the banks. It's not good for you to be here.
Yeah, anything else?
Out of respect for your late father, your guardian is willing to help you one last time. He will settle your debts on one condition. You must leave Europe.
Leave?
Immediately.
And if I refuse?
Those bonds checks. The bank has agreed to wait until tomorrow morning. If not settled by then, a charge of fraud will be filed. Your guardian makes this proposal in your best interests, I assure you.
Okay.
Where will you go?
Kenya sounds nice.
Confirmed on flight 37 to Nairobi. Will that be one way or round trip?
One way.
First class. What's this?
A farewell gift from your guardian.
Huh. You never gonna tell me, are you? My mysterious guardian is, or was.
I have told
you. Oh, yeah. You don't know.
He wishes to remain anonymous.
Why?
Could you sign here, please? Thank you. A nice flight.
Your attention, Mr. Sangara is invited to proceed to the UK Airways departure gate.
I'd like to have some flowers delivered to the Père Lachaise Cemetery. Your name is Anna Lays Beauvoir.
How much would you like to spend, sir?
This much.
You are irresponsible.
Oh, Morph. You pay for this? I'm flat broke. I guess this is it.
You're a troubled young man. Perhaps now that you're on your own, you will grow up.
Don't bet on it.
The package has been sent. Kenya. Yes, Kenya.
Karibu, welcome to Kenya.
Adventure of a lifetime.
Good. Thank you.
Hey, do you want to go on safari?
No, thanks.
Be good for you if you do it.
Hey, no offense. I mean, you're not the kind of guy I like to say no to, but really, I have no money. I'm broke. Can I get a lift into town? Thanks.
My name is Joaquin.
Frank. Safari business isn't too good, huh?
People scared of me. Maybe they think I stick their throat in the bush. Frank, why have you come to Africa?
Venture.
Huh? Here?
Why not? Thanks.
See you.
I hope business picks up.
Why?
Of his dreams, but dreams like that cost money.
My friend, I'm here. I've come all the way from Paris to make you the deal of your life. For you, $100. This is direct from Boucheron in Paris, $3,500 before taxes, and that was a steal. But I tell you what, since you're so in love with it, I'll let it go for $1,000.
$140.
$875, tops.
$175, but only because we have known each other for so long.
Deal. But you throw in a razor, some blades, a toothbrush, some cigarettes, some underwear, and a map of Kenya.
Does the underwear have to be new?
Yes. The toothbrush, too.
Frank's little transactions with Chandra just aren't enough. He needs something better and decides to go after the money where he knows he can find it.
I gave you a good deal!
Business that bad, huh? Remember me? I'm about to turn all that around for you. Meet your new partner, Frank Cymbali.
Frank sings the praises of a safari to tourists, sells them the services of Joachim, and changes their hard currency at a rate much more favorable than the official one.
Miss, would you like to go on safari, off the beaten track, your own white hunter, beautiful scenery?
Sounds exciting.
Great, let's go. Jeep's right out here, it's not to worry. He's got the best. Hey, Joachim!
Hey, help us, young woman. Put this in the back.
We can sit here.
Don't worry, he's a pussycat. Just don't forget to pay him. You're gonna have the adventure of a lifetime.
Luck smiles down on our hero.
I've been here before, but I don't believe I spoke to you. I met a woman on the terrace the other day, and she told me her name, and like an idiot, I forgot it. Let me describe her to you. I think she's staying here. She's tall, blondish, brownish hair, very beautiful, green eyes.
Brown eyes? Yes, I think I can help you back.
She found me. Hello?
Hello.
Good. I was afraid you might have checked out.
Oh, no, hardly. I work in the hotel, and I live here.
You do? Mm-hmm. How unusual. No, that's great. That must be so interesting. You get to meet many foreign, strange people from different countries, and would you like to have dinner with me tonight? By the way, my name is Frank Cymbali.
I'm Sarah Watkins.
Nice to meet you.
And what about your family? Still in London. Haven't seen them since I was 17. Mm. Yours?
My parents are both dead.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. My mother died when I was born, and my father when I was 6.
You lived with relatives?
No, I have no relatives. I have no family. It sounds sad, but I was shipped off to prep schools in Europe and the States, and I hated it. I had a guardian.
So what brought you to Kenya?
Oh, it seemed like a nice place to go. Very warm and beautiful. I was serious about wanting to move here. I really like to see the rooms. Please?
I guess I could show you my room. It's pretty much similar to the rest of them.
Thank you.
Right this way, ma'am. Watch your step.
Sit here, sir. All right?
Thank you.
Good.
Thank you. All right? You okay, sir?
Fine, sir.
You all right?
Yeah.
Have fun.
All set?
Or are you the pussycat?
Right.
Fun.
You all right?
Father's estate is worth 50 to 60 million US dollars. You've been robbed. My God. Mark Lavater, private detective, Paris.
Who would send you this? Is there any truth to it?
I don't know.
Your father had that kind of money?
We had a beautiful old house and servants, and I had a toy Ferrari, that's all I remember.
What are you gonna do?
I don't know. Hello, Air France. When's your next flight to Paris? Yeah, I'd like to make a reservation. Symbali. Frank. Thank you. Yeah, bye.
Young.
Don't worry, it's not contagious.
Let's take a walk. How did you get my name?
You tell me. This came with your letter.
That's my card, all right. Now, what's this about a letter? Postmark looks genuine. Good quality rag bond. Remington, maybe. Uneven impressions. Two-finger typist. Trace of perfume. Expensive. I'd say your secret admirer is a woman, middle-aged, well-to-do, who never learned to type.
I want to find out who sent me this letter and if what it says is true.
I'm expensive. $2,000 a week, plus expenses, plus...
I can afford it.
Can you? To me, you're just a boy driving a rented Rolls. For all I know, the suit's rented too.
I can have your first payment in a week, plus 10% of whatever we recover.
Fair enough. I start when I'm paid. How can I contact you?
You can't. I'll contact you.
Thanks to Joaquim, Frank's circle of acquaintances grows. Through him, he meets Romano, a local swindler who leads him to more profitable ventures.
My investigation was positive.
So the letter was right.
Your father's company was dismantled, erased, and rebuilt elsewhere without a trace. As embezzlement schemes go, it was brilliant. The letter said $50 or $60 million. More likely triple that.
Who was behind it?
I don't know. Whoever it was must now be very rich and very dangerous. Want my opinion? Forget about it. And get on with your life.
I need to pursue this, Mark. Will you help me?
It's going to cost.
Get the names. I'll get the money.
Somebody is making inquiries about the Crusoe business.
Who is it?
A private investigator from Paris.
Uh-huh. Who is he working for?
I'll find out.
Traffic in currency, he moves on to gold. The risks are higher, so are the profits.
Who he's working for?
How amusing.
I think you have nothing to fear. They were your father's partners. Alvin Bremer, out of Chicago, here in the real estate division. Ovius and Donaldson, they ran the South America operations. Henri Landau, Paris, he ran the European end. Will Scarlett, the financial genius. Dead. Did you know him?
Oh, yeah. I knew Scarlett.
Martin Jarl, traitor number one. He took the lion's share of your father's estate and laundered it through a Zurich bank.
Could he have been my guardian? That might explain why he wanted me out of Europe, though. Symbali name in the papers might pique curiosity, bring up something from the past.
I guess my job is finished.
No. No, it's just starting. I want to know everything about these bastards, right down to what they have for breakfast.
Frank,
I'm going after them.
I'm not Murder Incorporated.
I'm not asking you to be.
I'm just going to take from them what they took from my father. Money.
Frank doesn't want to let his revenge plan make him forget the appointment he set up with Romano in Hong Kong.
Hello. Checking in, Cimbali.
Would you like to fill out the form, please, sir?
Sarah? Oh,
what a surprise.
Oh, you were expecting someone else?
Yeah.
Mr. Cimbali?
Yes.
Your meeting's today. Be at the Kowloon Airport. 4 o'clock. Your lady friend is also invited.
Thank you.
Frank leaves Hong Kong to meet the mysterious and incredibly wealthy Mr. Hack, to whom he was recommended by Romano for a secret mission, one which should do his bank account a great deal of good.
Most grateful you could accept my invitation, Miss Watkins.
My pleasure, Mr. Hack.
Blossom of Jade, my niece, has consented to act as hostess. Ladies, please excuse us. Come, Mr. Cimbali, we'll take brandy and cigars in the library.
Thank you.
What do you know about gold and currency speculation?
Probably about as much as the average person. Absolutely nothing.
Good. I need you for an extremely confidential operation in Geneva. The only people who will know are in this room. It happens I have information of crucial importance. What I want you to do is perfectly legal. Your fee will be $2.5 million to be paid from the profits of the operation. That is, if you accept.
I accept.
Please be good enough to open the chest. $100 million, Mr. Cimbali. What do you think would happen if one day a man of my importance became displeased with you?
Oh, he'd probably have me killed.
Tomorrow I will place this money in your care. It would, of course, be best not to lose it.
I repeat, all passengers proceeding on to Geneva must stay on the aircraft. All passengers.
What is it, Sarah? You haven't said a word the whole flight.
I guess I'm not in a talkative mood. I'm sorry.
Where are you going?
To London, see my family.
You haven't seen them for years.
All the more reason. I'll call you.
Sarah's in a bad mood, and Frank has the sad premonition that he'll never see her again.
wish to deposit $100 million?
$101 million. These are the bank drafts from various banks in Hong Kong.
Thank you. And you wish to purchase on 20% margin $500 million in gold?
$505 million.
Not too late. Purchased at the current price of gold, expressed, of course, in US dollars, and payable 1 month from today.
Exactly.
May I see your passport? You're very young.
Marc Lavater has learned who advanced Landau the money to redo his restaurant. A certain character living in Paris nicknamed the Turk. And Marc has discovered his weakness. Women.
I missed you. Frankie, it's been a long time.
Well, how's the world's greatest sales lady?
Oh, sounds like you want something from me.
Doesn't everybody?
Oh,
no.
Frankie.
No, not that.
Okay, let's go over this again. You wait 20 minutes and...
Yeah, yeah. Then I come in with guns blazing.
Take no prisoners.
What service may a humble tar do for Mr. Frank Zimbali?
You hold the note for Henri Landau's renovation loan. I'd like to buy it.
It's not for sale. Anything else I can do for Mr. Zimbali?
Excuse me.
The Dow Industrials?
The results of the first race at Del Mar.
Well, I tell you what. I'll put $10,000 on the next race. If I win, you keep the purse, but sell me the note. If I lose, I leave, and you don't lose a cent. Deal?
But the second race has already started.
Oh, it doesn't matter. The race isn't over till the results are in.
An unusual proposition. I like that. But the horse you pick must come in first.
All right. $10,000 on... Silver Dragon.
A long shot at 16 to 1. You go broke playing the long shot.
Yes, but it's far more exhilarating than playing a sure thing.
Go and see if the results are in. Make yourself comfortable.
Thank you.
Anything in my humble home is yours.
Frankie, darling. Are you ready to leave? I've been waiting for you downstairs.
Uta, may I present the Turk?
Oh, very nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Excuse me.
What is it?
The race is over.
Then Silver Dragon.
He's still running.
Please sit down. What are you doing, my friend?
I lost. You won.
I like your style. You... want Landau's note so bad. Hell, I sell it to you.
Thank you. In return, I'll give you a tip. Buy gold against the dollar on margin.
Another long shot.
Let's just say that I'm going in big.
That's interesting. Let me consider it.
Monsieur Landau?
What can I do for you, monsieur?
cachet, Banque de la Provence. We hold your promissory note. We are calling it in. This is impossible. How could you have this note? You have 1 week. Should you fail to repay the loan, my bank will seize your restaurant and put it up for auction. Get out of my restaurant. Please, out.
My dear Henry, it's a very simple thing. A minor setback required me to temporarily transfer your note. There is no cause for alarm.
But I have only 7 days.
Relax, my friend. You'll have the money in six.
Are you certain?
99%. Take the Turk's advice. Don't give it another thought.
With the renovations, Henri's restaurant is worth at least $8 million. You agree, Mondo?
Agree.
How would you like to buy it for six?
Who's the boy?
Someone who can do you a great deal of good.
We have reason to believe Henri's will come up for auction within the week.
What do you want from us?
Take a week off. Go out of town, go fishing. When you return to Paris, Henri's will fall into your lap.
Of course, what you're proposing is strictly legal.
Of course.
I know today is the deadline, but give me another 24 hours and I'll have the money. Guaranteed. I could lose my job for this, but you look like an honest man. I'm willing to trust you.
I'm dreadfully sorry, but the money I was expecting did not arrive.
I was counting on you, you son of a bitch. You gave your word.
No need to be nasty, monsieur. I did my best. I said I was 99% sure. That still left some risk.
Martin, it's Henri. Henri Landau. I wouldn't be doing this. Forgive me, but I'm in great difficulty. No one will lend me money.
So?
Could you make a transfer to France through your bank by noon today?
And launder funds which are undeclared? And it will be illegal.
Don't talk to me about illegal, Martin. Someone is setting me up. Who, I don't know. But if I go down...
Never contact me again.
Now that the Landau affair is out of the way, it's time for Frank to attack Hovius and Donaldson.
Frankie, I adore you. I love you. You made me a fortune.
What are you talking about?
Haven't you heard? It's in the news. The Americans just went off the gold standard. It's going crazy. The price went up. You are rich.
So that's what Hawk knew.
What was that?
Nothing, nothing.
Listen, Frankie. I want in on your next deal.
Fine, fine, fine. But listen, I need you to do me a favor first. Mark Lavender said you could help me out. I need an introduction to someone in the Bahamas named Robert Zara. Do you know him?
He is very dangerous, Frank.
Is there a problem?
I'll get back to you.
All right. Frank Cimbali. Listen, you know that 505 million? Sell it.
Yeah, well, here, Cimbali.
By the way, what was the profit on that?
$42.5 million US.
Listen, send $4 million of that to my bank in the Bahamas and the rest of the account in the Philippines, all right?
Frank feels he owes Mr. Hack a great deal. Thanks to him, his income bracket has taken a tremendous leap in the right direction.
Frank, you there?
Lavater.
I got the story on your friend Hack. Seems he borrowed that 100 million from the Red Chinese without their permission.
Listen, the money's in an account in the Philippines. Can you get it to them as quickly as possible? I don't want to end up like Hawk.
I'll slip it under their embassy door.
Don't forget their interest. Bye-bye.
Frank would love to stay in this lovely setting for a few hours, but thanks to the Turk, he has an appointment with Robert Zara, the man who will help him finish off Hovius and Donaldson.
Frankie, Robert Zara, it's set. Let me tell you about him. He's a man of humble beginnings. His father was a truck driver, but Zara had ambition. And by the time he was 40, he was the Sultan of Wall Street. Then the money went to his head. 2 years ago, he disappeared, along with 300 million in mutual funds. 6 months ago, he surfaces in the Bahamas. In exchange for investing in their operations, his friends provided him with safe haven in their version of paradise.
Minutes, you forgot they're even here.
Who? See, you forgot already. Oh, no, thanks. I don't drink. But, seems like a good time to start.
I'm listening.
James Hovius and John Donaldson own International Fruit and HDY Chemical, which pretty much owns San Marcos.
Yes, I heard, O'Donnell. You know, please?
2 years ago, you had dinner with him at the Savoy Club in London.
You're well informed, huh?
What about Hovius?
We swim in the same ocean, but he's no friend of mine.
They're no friends of mine, either.
So the Turk said. Why come to me?
Because you have contacts in the truckers' union. Now, there's talk of a big strike in San Marcos. When that hits, I want Hovius and Donaldson singled out. Without trucks, their processing plants will grind to a halt. I want their businesses destroyed.
Interesting. And in return?
In return, I contribute $1 million to the truckers' strike fund.
Make it 2 million. One in advance, and you must decide now.
That's a bit more than I can afford. But say I did manage to find the second million. What exactly am I getting?
Hovius and Donaldson will be destroyed. You have my word.
Oh, what the heck? It's only money.
Frank calls a temporary halt to his race for money and revenge and returns to his roots, to the house where he and his father lived together.
Thank you.
He had been happy here, a child spoiled by his father and his father's friends. This little Ferrari was a gift from his father's best friend, Will Scarlet.
Frankie, Frankie, come on. Can you come and see what Mr. Scarlet brought you?
Get in, sir. I'm gonna take a picture.
Yeah.
All
right.
Are you happy, Frankie? Ta-da!
It was in this house that he saw his father die, just after a mysterious phone conversation.
Was sagen Sie? Nein, das ist meine Idee. Ja, ich bitte Sie, das ist meine Gesellschaft. Nein, das dürfen Sie nicht machen. Was? Was sagen Sie? Aber wenn Sie das machen, das bin ich kaputt.
Reported in yet another South American republic. This was the scene yesterday downtown in the capital city of San Marcos. The State Department has confirmed that the country's president, Julio Ulloa, was assassinated 2 days ago. A military junta has now been set up to run the country pending free democratic elections. Meanwhile, it has been reported that all foreign-owned businesses have been nationalized and their assets frozen, including the U.S. conglomerate International Fruit and HDY Chemical.
Son of a bitch.
That is not possible, Herr Jarl. 165 million we made in loans to Hovius and Donaldson in San Marcos have created a serious cash problem.
The generals ransacked the treasury before they fled.
We have filed suit in the World Court, but our chances of recovery are slight. It is a very serious problem. We may have to consider selling Curaçao too to raise capital.
Hello.
Hello, Frank. It's Mark. I have news. You won't be going to Chicago. Bremer is dead. Heart attack.
Well, yes, I suppose I should be happy, but I'm not.
Don't worry, I have friends in the IRS. I'll get to work on Yaz's dossier right away.
I don't want him dying on you, too. About your friends.
The Red Chinese. They got my anonymous tip. You're off the hook, so to speak.
Thanks, Mark. I guess I'll have to wait a bit before I start on Martin Yall.
The truth is, even with $4 million, you were no threat to him.
Yeah, I cost him a bundle in San Marcos.
Lucky accident.
Every bit helps.
I guess I can't talk you into giving it up.
Giving what up?
Your obsession with Martin Yall.
No.
I didn't think so.
In New York, Frank runs into David Sussman, an old friend. After lots of showing off, he tells Frank about the real estate slump in Florida, which gives our hero an idea.
might have exaggerated slightly about the state of the real estate market.
So business is not good.
Well, actually, it sucks. It's death, man.
I thought real estate was booming.
Yeah, sure, in New York. I mean, goddamn Florida. Condos, you can't get rid of them.
Really? How many do you have?
Me, I don't have any, but my bank's stuck with thousands. It's slump, man, with a capital S. It's really depressing.
Huh.
Mr. Zimbali, I agreed to see you only because Mr. Sussman spoke highly of you. I'm a busy man. You have 2 minutes.
Mr. Adams, you've got some terrific properties in Florida. Well-built, reasonably priced, and every window looks out on paradise. But, unfortunately, the country's in the middle of a recession. And your bank is stuck with $300 million worth of bad mortgages. I'm sure your shareholders can't be too pleased about that, and your board of directors probably isn't patting you on the back either.
Get to the point, Mr. Zimbali. You have 30 seconds.
You can't sell those units in Florida. I can. I know who the buyers are, and I know how to reach them.
You have 10 minutes.
Once in Florida, Frank doesn't waste any time. He contacts real estate agents, prospective customers, and when he's finally ready to sell, he puts all his friends in on the deal. And first and foremost, the Turk.
Hello.
Hello, Uta. How's it going?
Oh, Frankie, darling.
Listen, can I talk to the Turk?
Sure, just a second.
Frankie, I love you. Like selling Rolls Royces to the royalty. Everyone simply must have one.
Yeah, well, it's not going to take me where I want to go. I need to make some real money.
Frankie, you're getting worse, not better.
Well, it's Adams Bank is going to make all the money on this, not us.
That's real estate. You don't make real money unless you own the buildings.
You're absolutely right. Turk, hold the sales. Pass the word. I need to find 10 buyers that can give me $50,000 for each condo. As soon as you can.
I have them now.
It has to be in cash.
Cash? Or my clients go through banks.
Well, then find some new ones.
Frankie, I can smell another deal.
Sunbelt Development.
Frankie, get over here. It's an emergency.
What's up, Turk?
I can't talk on the phone. Come as soon as you can.
But just tell me, is it good news?
It could be wonderful. He's a Saudi prince. More money than God. All through my pitch, he didn't say a word. When he finally spoke, he asked me, instead of buying five, suppose I buy 500? He'll have his advisor with him, a financial wizard named Fedzali.
You are the first to think to look for buyers outside the United States? If your predictions about the recession are correct, then
the condos will double or even triple in value. If we buy the buildings, leveraging will make us at least 10 times that.
Why share this windfall with us?
Well, I've bought some buildings with different partners, but we can't raise money fast enough.
The market is showing signs of life. I have to act now, or the opportunity's lost.
Your share?
I get a commission on the unit sold, but also a piece of the action.
Your Highness, this man may be young in years, but he's got the touch.
You have much confidence in him?
Yes.
Are you investing?
Yes. Though compared to you, I'm but a poor man. if you will excuse us, Your Highness, we'll be at the bar so you can discuss this proposal in private. Don't look. Let them make a decision.
What do you think our odds are?
You did fine, my friend. Now they're looking at us. They are ready.
Gentlemen.
Mr. Cimbali, I knew your father. In fact, he was a friend. But to be a man's friend does not necessarily mean placing one's confidence in that man's son. However, on my advice, Prince Aziz is now prepared to invest $250 million. Something wrong, Mr. Cimbali?
Oh, things couldn't be better.
That's the last one in that long.
Champagne. Best money can buy.
At this rate, Curaçao 2 may not meet our projections.
And our cash flow?
Still a concern.
We must increase our market share. We will move into North America and Asia.
But that is Unicorn territory.
We will be in violation of our non-aggression pact.
If we move into their market, the chemical industry will be totally destabilized. We will be cutting each other's throats. We've been 13 years without competition.
But more important, Herr Yal, we do not have the money.
L'audace, mes amis, toujours l'audace. Attack, gentlemen, you must always attack.
Got a minute?
Frank, what a wonderful surprise. When did you get to Paris?
Just today.
You look wonderful, young. Youth is sickening.
I brought you something.
You have been busy.
7 days a week, 12 hours a day for months. I'm almost ready.
Yal has tens of millions. What have you got, Frank? A couple of million in commissions.
That's what I want everyone to think. I've got $70 million in Liechtenstein. Or should I say 69.5?
Make it 70. I don't want your money.
What, are you quitting on me?
When we started this, for me it was just another job. Now it's different. You want justice. My motive is less pure.
What's happened, Mark? What did you find out?
For now, that's between me and Yal. I'll have his dossier ready when you get back from Canada.
Canada? Why the hell would I go to Canada?
To see Will Scarlet.
Will Scarlet's dead.
Not anymore.
private property.
I'm here to see Will Scarlet.
Mr. Scarlet sees no one.
Give him this. He'll see me.
Mr. Scarlet does not read.
Well, then read it to him. It says Frank Cimbali. He'll see me.
This. That's nothing yet, but you insisted. Ferrari.
It had a number.
7. Hovis, Donaldson, Bremer, Landau, finished. It leaves the masterminds. Y'all, and you.
The idea was yours, the scheme was mine. I've been sick for a long time. I was getting worse. When I found out there was no cure, my wife left me. I can't blame her. I was desperate. You all promised me a great deal of money. But in return, I had to devise a plan to dismantle your father's company and funnel the assets into his new company, Curaçao 2. It was the most difficult decision I ever made. I cared about your father and about you.
You expect me to believe that?
Best schools, cars, vacations, spending money. Always more spending money.
You. You're my guardian. There's nothing worse I could do to you. The letter you sent me in Kenya.
What letter?
Why did you abandon me in Kenya?
It was time for you to grow up. Being a man means taking responsibility for your actions.
And living with the consequences. My father's house in Saint-Tropez, do you own it?
If I did, I would give it to you.
I'm going after y'all.
With money?
$70 million.
Not enough. Besides his bank and his own money, he has the confidence and respect of the Swiss bankers. You might cause him some trouble, cause him to take a loss, but in the end, you bankrupt yourself, that's all.
So you're saying it can't be done?
Alone, not a chance. But with my help, I'll tell you, we were playing chess. Together, we could checkmate y'all in 9 moves. Let me help you. You'd get what you want. And I could make peace with your father's memory. Their egos are exceeded only by their abilities. I know. I taught them myself.
Now, the beauty of the plan is in its simplicity. We inflate the price of Unichem, virtually forcing y'all to buy it. We even give him the money to buy it. Then, when he's in over his head, we yank the money away, wipe him out. Then we expose how he swindled my father and finish him off. Checkmate in 9 moves. Rosen, you'll go to Zurich to close the deal. Franco, you're in charge of Operation Roundup. Anna, you'll be the only one that deals with y'all directly. Are there any questions before we start?
Well, I've heard better plans from guys who got caught knocking over mom and pop stores.
He'll never go for it.
Don't underestimate his greed.
This whole thing is ridiculous. I, for one, don't want any part of it.
Well, I guess Will Scarlet underestimated you guys.
Will Scarlet? How do you know Scarlet?
He was my guardian, my father's best friend.
Why didn't you say so?
I'd heard he died.
A vicious rumor that Mr. Scarlet started himself. He requests anonymity, but sends this letter by way of introduction.
Now, on to move number 2. Make available to y'all the capital he will need later on. In this case, the key is obviously Vesali. It's up to you to convince him.
$950 million. It is a great deal of money, yes?
$350 to me in New York, $600 deposited to y'all's bank in Zurich.
The prince was pleased with our venture in Florida, but this is a far riskier proposition.
But if everything goes according to plan, the prince will own both Unichem and Curacao, too.
And your fee?
No fee. In fact, every share I sell the prince costs me $100. Overhead, lawyer's fees.
For you, this is not very good business.
No, it's not. But this has nothing to do with business. For me, it's a personal matter.
I will recommend the prince come into the deal, but only for the money that will go to Yal's bank. The rest, it is your concern. I have no love for Yal either, but as the English say, vengeance is a dish which must be eaten cold.
Martin, my old friend. You're looking well.
Once you have the money in place, you are ready for move number 3.
Pay a visit to Unichem's largest shareholder, Aaron Stern. Stern hoped his grandson would take over, but the boy died recently in a bizarre airplane accident. Stern hasn't been the same since. He's anxious to retire and has been waiting for a reasonable offer. Yours will be more than that.
You're offering $350 a share for shares which have never reached 300 and today are trading at less than 230.
That's correct.
And that price is good for all my shares.
Yeah.
$410,000 shares times $350 each.
$143,500,000.
Very good. I can see why you're the company's largest shareholder. That's like cash, by the way. Well, apparently you still need time to make up your mind, so I'll come back tomorrow for your decision. Mr. Stern?
Move 4. After Stern, go immediately to the other major shareholder, Mel Glatzman. You'll find him a tough customer and not anxious to sell.
$350 a share has my attention. $400 would have my interest.
$350 per is more than generous.
When someone offers $120 above market price, I have to ask myself, why is he doing this? Does he know something that I don't? And if it's worth this much to him, maybe it's worth more to somebody else.
You have 24 hours.
Get me Martin Jarl in Geneva.
Well, if that doesn't start the ball rolling, I don't know what will.
Now it's up to Jarl.
That's move number 5.
Don't count on it.
$350 a share is already far beyond its current value. Above 400, ridiculous.
Offer 380. Use our Panama holding company. Now, what is this? Something else?
Herr Jarl, you realize this means a public tender offer.
Yeah, so?
There are 900,000 shares outstanding at $380 per share.
If all the shareholders should come forward, we would have to buy them all. Failure to do so would mean bankruptcy.
And ruin. We do not have the money.
Gentlemen, where is your imagination? I have already foreseen these dangers and overcome them. 2 hours ago, I sold Kurosawa too. My old friend, Fisali, bought it for $230 million. Of course, I will stay on as president in order to retain effective control. For a man of Fisali's limited sophistication, it would be an ideal situation. As for the public tender offer, put your minds at rest. I have secured from Fisali a pledge to buy all Unichem shares which are offered for sale. Gentlemen, in 30 days, I will own Unichem and control Kurosawa. I think that will be a most convenient arrangement, yeah?
Y'all went for it. He bought out Stern and Glassman for $380 per, and he made the public tender offer.
Time for move 6.
Operation Roundup. Clock's running, gentlemen. We have 30 days. Let's do it.
fountain now. Peter, please, let's see how we're doing.
Absolutely. Most certainly. So then you would be willing to sell those 25 shares of Unicam, Mrs. Fitchner?
Who would you consider trading them for? Some IBM or General Motors Class A?
Yes, sir, we're offering you a lot more than you paid for them. No, no, sir, there's no cash.
Great.
Great, 150 shares at 260. Thank you very much.
Hello?
Frank, it's Lavater. Can you talk?
Sir, what is it?
You have a traitor in your operation. I don't know who it is, but I'm working on it. In the meantime, watch your back.
Thanks. 257? Yes, ma'am. You've got that?
Perhaps I go to New York and find out who is behind this.
There's no need. It's the Cimbali boy.
Do you want me to?
No. No, let him be. He's digging his own grave, not mine.
Yeah, but Frank, that's just a small fry. Tomorrow we go after the big investors.
They'll be easy to convince, especially when we offer them $418 a share.
It's costing me a fortune.
Revenge is an expensive luxury.
Not revenge, justice.
2,000 shares at 360. It's a once-in-a-lifetime deal, Mr. Foster.
I need your Unicam shares, Mr. Hicks.
Sister Catherine, if you sell right now, you have enough money to float the orphanage and burn the mortgage.
5 days.
Frank, what's the count? The big guns came through. 734,000 purchased, 140,000 in the Protection Association.
That's 874,000.
Hello.
Frank.
Fazali, where are you?
Heathrow. My favorite uncle is gravely ill. I must be at his side. For the next 10 days, I will be in the desert.
I understand. Tell your uncle I hope he feels better. He's always in place. We're ready to spring the trap. The limo's waiting downstairs. Your plane leaves in an hour. Good luck.
All right.
Good luck.
Take care.
Okay, Harvard. Time for move 7.
Y'all here?
It's Anna Lupino, senior partner with Lupino, Lupino and Rosen. On behalf of my client, I am taking up your public tender offer on his Unicam shares.
Very well. How many shares?
734,000 at $380 per share. The total, Mr. Yall, is $278,920,000. I needn't remind you of your obligation to take up these shares. By midnight Friday, Zurich time.
I see. Very well. Let me have your number. I will call you back. Get me for Sally. Fazali, good.
Mr. Fazali has returned to Egypt, Terial. He is in the desert and cannot be reached for 10 days.
Well, send Morph to look for him. This is urgent.
Morph is away on business.
Oh, what business?
He said you knew about it.
Huh. I see. Very well, never mind. Send someone else. Contact Herr Dollinger. Tell him I request an urgent meeting with the Bankers' Council. Oh, and one more thing.
Aren't we forgetting something?
What?
But what about Yael's banker friends?
Well, that's move number 8.
Which is?
Hey, you don't want me to spoil the surprise, do you? Drink up.
Yeah, it's me. What do you mean the check bounced? No, wait a minute.
Just go back to your bank tomorrow. I'm sure the check will clear. Frank, your checks are bouncing. What the hell happened?
Some kind of screw-up. I'll call the bank.
It's
Give me
Henry
Clay Adams, Long Island. Hello, Cimbala here. What do you mean I'm overdrawn? But, all right, okay.
I'll put him
I'll
on.
I'll get right on it. Thank you.
Talk to Mr. Adams.
Mr. Adams, what's going on?
You must be psychic, son. I was just about to call you.
The money, it's not in the account. Where is it?
Well, the investors had a change of heart. I hope this doesn't put a damper on your plans.
Bastard. The old sucker punch. Should have seen it coming. Go through my Rolodex. Call them all. Tell them I need to borrow some money. Have Lupino find Fazzoli. Move 8's gonna have to wait. Oh, call Lavender. Tell him to hold off on Move 9 till I get this mess settled. I'm gonna go to the bank, stall for time.
It seems, gentlemen, that the public tender offer has been withdrawn. So, for the moment, it will not be necessary for me to draw on the funds that you so kindly committed. Please, a bottle of our best schnapps.
Ah. Any word from my friends?
I don't know what they see in you. But who am I to tell them how to spend their money?
What did you hear?
Scarlett's coming in for 75 million. He said something about it belonging to you anyhow. Turk pledged 10 million. Uta added another million. David Sussman is in for 3 million. Rosen called. Still no sign of Fazzoli. Chandra said he'd love to help, but he can't get his money out of Kenya.
We're almost halfway there.
Frank, you've lost.
Always the optimist, huh, Lupino?
Just a realist. The good don't always win. The bad aren't always punished. And sometimes the wrong people end up with all the money.
Frank, Anna, look at this.
Banker Martin Yall exposed as former Nazi. During World War II, Martin Yall provided the Nazis with access to numbered accounts held by wealthy Jews, in clear violation of Swiss banking secrecy laws. The equivalent of hundreds of millions of dollars went into Hitler's war chest while the account holders went to the death camps.
Brilliant. Yall won't be able to raise cab fare.
What move was this?
It wasn't.
You mean you weren't behind this?
No, but I know who was. Time for Move 8.
Yeah?
Anna Lupino again from New York.
Ah, I wasn't expecting your call, Miss Lupino. I've heard rumors that your financing fell through at the last minute and that you had nothing to sell.
Oh, a minor setback, but that has been resolved. The number of shares has changed slightly. It is now 400,000.
Very well, I will try to arrange a transfer of funds. Of course, I will require a documentation of ownership.
But, Mr. Yall, I have reason to believe you will shortly have a problem with your financing.
No, that is not the case.
Mr. Yall, have you seen today's, I guess it would be your late afternoon papers? I suggest you look at them and call me back. I may be able to help.
Thank you. What are you offering?
I am authorized to offer you $500,000 in exchange for the 670,000 Unichem shares now in your possession.
Those shares are worth more than $250 million, and you are offering 500,000? I don't have time for such foolishness.
Oh, one more thing, Mr. Yal. In exchange for your block of Unichem shares, my client will make a written pledge to take over your public tender offer and fulfill it by the deadline, which is less than 2 hours away.
And if I refuse?
Then I will be forced to file a complaint with the SEC, the police, and your Swiss Banking Commission. One of my associates, Mr. Rosen, is waiting at the Swiss National Bank, across the street from your office. He has the necessary papers. I think he's yours, Frank. You did it.
No. We did. Thanks. Better go home, get some sleep.
Good luck.
How did he know about y'all?
You told me to look into Morph. I couldn't trace him back before 46. I dug deeper and found out he was in the SS, in charge of tracing Jewish numbered accounts. After the war, an American intelligence officer smuggled him into Switzerland in exchange for fingering Russian agents in Berlin.
Scarlet.
Thank you, Governors, for convening on such short notice. We are all aware of the serious allegations which have appeared in the world press. Our colleague, Herr Yal, has requested this meeting to defend his reputation and that of his bank. But before we proceed, the senior counsel has decided there is another matter.
Oh, by the way, I found out who owns the house in Saint-Tropez.
Who?
You.
Me?
Your father saw what was coming, but only had time to save the house. He transferred it to a certain Madame Vals, and she kept it for you all these years. My crystal ball. She was, how should I put it, a very close friend of your father's.
She was the one that sent the letter.
Gentlemen, I have here a signed deposition which has great bearing on the matter before you. With your permission, I will also play a tape detailing how 15 years ago, Martin Yal committed embezzlement and fraud on an unprecedented scale. A signed confession. from a longtime associate of Martin Yarl's, Alfred Morf. That includes conspiracy to commit murder.
Mr. Chairman, I protest.
Herr Richter, you are out of order.
Mr. Lavater, please continue.
After you listen to the tape, I will hand out the deposition.
I, William Scarlett, freely confess that while in the employ of Martin Yarl and others, and following his explicit instructions, I secretly and fraudulently transferred the corporate assets from Curaçao 1, owned by Andrea Cimbali, to Curaçao 2, owned by Martin Yarl.
Now the world sees you for what you are.
Cimbali? I must compliment you. Your scheme was a most awkward one, but nevertheless effective.
You still have to answer for my father's death.
No. He died of ambition, your father.
He died from your greed.
Your father was no better than the rest of us. Smuggling money out of Italy to my bank. That's how his fortune started. It began with a crime.
You're lying.
You believe what you want to believe. Lies, the truth. Doesn't matter now. All that matters is money.
To you?
Let me tell you about money. She is a whore. She has a life, a power, and a language all her own. And she stays with who offers her most. That is why, for the moment, she stays with you. Because for the moment, you have learned how to stroke, how to manipulate slowly.
Justice.
No one man can bring justice. If you think by killing me it will bring you justice, do it. I could have had you killed. Many times.
I know.
Your father was a fool. Wouldn't listen. I never wanted him to die. He was my friend. Of course.
In business, there are no friends.